All right, you guys, we're gonna get going with our ramp. So today we have a lot of options for each exercise. Can everybody hear me okay? Audio is okay? Thumbs up, good deal, okay. So we've got core circuit, a big circuit, similar format to last week. Strength and metabolic for everyone that voted, thank you. We've got lots of options. So I'll have options for all standing today. I'll have options for, and then I'll have three options. One that's standing, one that might not be standing, and then one if you wanna like really push yourself today with strength. So we're gonna go ahead and get started with our ramp, with our warm-up. For those of you that are new, RAMP is just acronym for readiness, activation, movement, prep. It's basically our warm-up. You don't have to remember what that means. But go ahead and get into your supine breathing drill, laying down flat on your back. If you wanna stand for this, A-okay. If you wanna sit down, totally fine. Really start pulling that air deep into the belly and start separating your headspace from real life as you enter your headspace for your workout. This is your 45 minutes to focus on yourself for the day. Most of our life situations, we don't really get another 45 minutes straight in our day just to focus on ourselves. So really maximize this time that you're practicing this radical self-love. All right. Once you're done with that, we're gonna come up to all fours. If you guys are okay with getting on the floor for this stuff, that would be awesome if you can do it a little bit. If not, that's okay. You can stand. You can stay standing here. And then what I'm gonna have you do is bend over, and then you're gonna open up that chest with the hand on the nape of the neck, okay? So quadruped, T-spine, external rotation. If you're following Nico here, hand on the nape of the neck. Rolls, elbow comes into the opposite side, and then following your elbow with your eyes, you open up. We're gonna go five on each side. So really notice how Nico's keeping his hips square. He's not shifting his hips. Five towards the front, and then five with your back hand. This should really get some mobility, some movement in this upper spine and in the shoulders. Get the juices flowing. I like what I'm seeing, guys. Once you hit five on each side, we're gonna move into our sideline clamshell. I'm gonna do this one with you guys. So as you all know by now, hopefully, come down to your beach vacay pose. Nico and I are both gonna do this one. So biggest thing, Nico will do it this way, I'll do it this way. Really notice how my heels, knees, and hips are stacked. I'm not gonna open them up at all. So I'm gonna pry that knee open just like a clam, hold for a second at the top, and then bring right back down. We're gonna go five on each side, really activating the glutes here, getting them warmed up. You'll notice Nico's hand is on his thigh. If that's comfortable for you, that's great. If you'd rather put it in front of your stomach to help with balance, that's great too. Once you hit five on one side, flip over to the other. So really watch those hips to make sure that you're not opening up like this. Top of that rep. Squeeze that top glute. You're with me, one more. All right, nice work, you guys. Coming up to standing, we're gonna do our toe touch progression. So keep in mind, you can always keep your knees as bent as you need, but you're just gonna fold over. If you can touch the ground, you're welcome to put weight onto your hands or bend your knees and just go to a spot that feels good for you. Continually focusing on relaxing that low back, that sacral area that's kind of between where your butt starts and your back starts. That's what you're relaxing. We're gonna hang here for about 30 seconds. A little more than halfway through. You can kind of rotate your hips if you want. Find a spot that has more tension. Just do what feels good for your body. As I said, this is your workout. All right, and then roll up slowly one vertebrae at a time when you are done. All right, we're gonna move into walking leg cradles. So we're working the balance. What you're doing is you're lifting the knee just as high as you can. You can grab onto your knee or you can just hold it here, single leg stance, for about 3 seconds. And then you're taking a step and switching sides. So if you want to hug your knee into your chest, you can, or you're holding that balance. You're welcome to have arms out for airplane. 3 times on each leg. Try and hold for 5 seconds that balance each time. So if you're going with me, this is our second one. We've got some single leg work today, so we want to warm up our balance. All right, last one here. So I think I actually did an extra. Okay. We are going to move right into our core circuit. So grab a sip of water if you need. I'm going to get our timer going because we are working in time intervals today. Where the heck did my timer go? Okay. So as I said, we have our big circuit with 3 moves, lots of options, and then we have our finisher, energy systems training. So circuit, core first. So core first, we have quadruped bird dog. So Nico's gonna demo this for us. If you're getting down on the floor today, you're gonna come down to quadruped, hands and knees stacked right under the hips and shoulders. And then you're gonna take opposite arm and opposite leg. So, and watch how Nico holds in and almost tries to touch his knee to his elbow without moving his back. And then go ahead and come back out and then bring that knee and elbow back in. All right, so there's option one. Option two, still opposite leg, opposite arm. By the way, you guys, let's start getting that heart rate up. Just start bouncing a little bit. All right, go ahead and show us, Nico. So extending the arm and the leg and then back into the ground. So you're gonna touch on the ground each time. With that hand, you're gonna touch the ground too. Yep, right there. So do a couple more reps like that. Yeah, so biggest thing here, you guys, I don't wanna see your low back arch. So see how, go ahead and sink your back. Sink your back. Yeah, I don't wanna see any arch low back like that. I want you to really zip up that rib cage, tighten it up, keep that core steady. Okay, standing option here. You may want to wait if you want to get like a weight or a soup can or your water bottle or something. Opposite leg, opposite arm. If you're holding a weight, you'd hold it in this hand. And you're going to hold for, we're doing 20 second intervals. So you'll hold for 10 seconds on one side. I'll tell you when to switch to the other side. If you lose your balance, just tap, go back into it, laugh it off. We all do it. All right. That is our first movement. Second one is top of push-up hold, shoulder taps. So if you're down in top of push-up hold, and then we're just gonna alternate, Nico's gonna tap opposite shoulder. So biggest thing we're looking for here, guys, go ahead and rotate to the side, Nico, so we can see your feet. You have kind of a wide base of support here because when you lift off that opposite hand, you're gonna want that wide base of support. So don't have your feet super narrow for this. The other biggest thing you're looking for here, go ahead and do a few reps, Nico. Notice how his hips are still. Now show us when they move, Nico. We don't want to see moving hips like this, flat and steady. I want you to pretend like I'm in your living room and I'm gonna come set my coffee mug down on your back and it can't fall off the whole time, okay? If you are standing today, we have a knee tuck with a lateral extension. So using your core to lift your knee laterally to the outside, you're gonna lift up and then crunch down. What you're looking for here is you're leading that crunch with your rib cage, not your elbow. So here I'm leading with my rib cage. Here I'm leading with my elbow. So think, lead with the rib cage, not the elbow, rib cage. And that's gonna activate your core a lot more. Okay, that was a lot of explaining. We're gonna jump right into it. Anybody have questions on core circuit? We have quadruped, or we have our bird dog, whatever your option is there. And then top of push-up hold, shoulder taps, or your knee tuck with lateral extension. Follow me. If you don't get it on the first round, you'll get it on this. You'll get it by the second. I'm gonna get our music going, our real workout music. All right, you guys will let me know if the music is too loud. We are gonna get going with our quadruped bird dog. We've got 20 seconds of work, 20 seconds of recovery. We're starting in 5. Nico's got your quadruped. I've got your standing. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Opposite leg, opposite arm. Squeeze everything. If you are standing, you're switching sides now. 3, 2, 1. Recover. You've got a short recovery today, 20 seconds, and we are right into those top of push-up hold, shoulder taps, or knee tuck with lateral extension. We are going in 5, 3, 2, 1. Keep those hips square if you're in top of push-up hold, and lead with the ribs if you're standing today. Five seconds, stick with the movement. 3, 2, 1, bring it down. All right, back to your bird dog, whatever your option is. Now you know where we're at. 10 more seconds, these breaks are short. I'm gonna show you guys with a weight on this standing quadruped. All right, we're going in 3, 2, 1. You're standing, go ahead and switch sides. Make sure you switch arms if you're holding a weight. Really nice work keeping your hips square, everyone. All right, bring it down, recover. You got 20 seconds. Back to those top of push-up hold, shoulder taps, or our knee tuck. Lateral extension. We're going in 5, 3, 2, 1. Make sure you're lifting those knees with your abs. You want to make anything harder, slow it down, resist gravity. All right, you got 3 seconds. 2, 1, recover. Nice work, you guys. All right, round 3, back to our bird dogs. You got 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Drive that knee and arm. Switch sides if you're standing. In these last 10 seconds, I want everybody to think action figure. Create all that tension in your body. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Work, you guys. Back to our shoulder taps. Last round of shoulder taps. We're going in 6 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Last round. Drive with those abs. Keep those hips square. Widen your base of support if you need to, especially if you start feeling it in the back. 5 seconds, stick with the movement. Keep driving with the rib cage. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Nice work, you guys. Give you about 30 seconds to recover. Once you've hit about 30 seconds, I'll try and remember to remind you, but make sure you start getting that heart rate up again, whether you're running in place or if you want to do side jumps, boxer bounce, anything you want. You can do jump rope too. All right. Our big circuit. Let me turn the music down. Okay. All right. We've got 3 big moves. First, we have single leg hip bridge with a knee extension. So Nico's going to demo this one for us. So you're coming down to your back. Palms are facing the sky. Nico's going to drive his hips up in that bridge. And then what he's going to do is he's going to extend one knee. So we want to line that knee up with the opposite knee. Don't want it to be too high or dropping way too low. That's option 1. Go ahead and drop. You can switch legs too if you want. Option 2, go ahead and drive the hips up and then 90 degree at that march. This is option 2. These are great for hip stability. So you're really keeping those hips square. Nico, go ahead and show us option 1 again. It doesn't matter if you're doing option 1 or 2. Drop that right hip. You don't want to see those hips drop. Drive up into the ceiling, driving those hip bones higher and higher and higher. All right, thank you, Nico. If you are standing today, you are doing a single leg RDL. So we're working on your balance. You can do airplane, and if you want to be next to a wall or something like that to kind of help with balance, A-okay. With those single leg RDLs, it's exactly like a deadlift where you're driving your hips back. So if you've never done a deadlift before, what I want you to think of is like you have too many grocery bags and you're trying to bring them in from your car, and so you push the car door closed with your butt. When you push the car door closed with your butt, you don't drop your butt down. You drive it back into the door behind you, right? That's that feeling. That's that motion we're going for. Now we're just gonna do it with one leg. So you're still driving the hips back, and I'm one long line from my heel to my head. This is a lot of balance work. So if you wanna tap a wall or something next to you, you can. You are aiming to hold this for a full 15 seconds, and I will tell you when to switch. Same thing. If you fall or lose your balance, just pop back up, laugh it off. It's okay. Unless you're hurt, then let us know. Okay, there's number one. Next, we have our eccentric push-ups. We have done these in the past. Some of you may remember them. It's lower, slow on the low. So Nico's gonna demo this for us. Our tempo is 3 seconds on the way down, 1 second at the bottom, and then 1 second on the way up. Lots of options with our push-ups here. Nico, go ahead and show us from the side. So obviously we have an option on our feet. Quickly, we'll go through the other options. Next option you have, lower on your feet, plant the knees, push up. Next option you have, all on the knees. 3, 2, 1 on the way down, 1, hold, 1 on the way up. Yep, and then we have tabletop. Big thing if you're doing tabletop today, which tabletop's still really hard, make sure those hands are wide enough and notice how Nico's dipping his head like a tea kettle spout. Not just dropping directly below, but dipping yourself. Those are your three options here. If you have stairs or a chair or something that's stable that you want to elevate your push-ups on, always an option. Just make sure it's really stable. Okay, last move. If you guys haven't started getting your heart rate up already, make sure you start now. All right, last move, we have step, squat, shoot, and a run back. We have done these before too. You can do these high impact or you can do these low impact. Nico and I are gonna do a couple reps. You're gonna wanna start back in the back of your space. You're stepping right into a right foot squat and then shooting like you're shooting a basketball. And then left foot shoot and then jog back to the start. That's one rep. So fast, my reps look like this. We're going for speed here, okay? So you can go at your own pace. If you're going low impact, step into that squat, shoot without the jump. Left side, shoot without the jump, march back, okay? Those are our three moves. Core work, we did 20 seconds of work, 20 seconds of recovery. Now we're moving up to 30 second intervals. So, we are gonna get going. Everybody good on the moves? Anybody have questions? Feeling good? Thumbs up? All right, good, okay. I'm gonna turn the music up and we're gonna get going again. Grab that sip of water if you need. And we are gonna start with single leg RDL or your single leg hip bridge with your knee extension. We're gonna get going in about 10 seconds, so make your way down. What one are you doing? I'll do single leg RDL. Okay, we're gonna get going in 5 seconds, so find your position. Remember your options, and in 3, 2, 1, let's go. If you are single leg RDL, I will tell you when to switch. You are holding for 15 seconds. So everybody's holding for 15 seconds on one side. 3, 2, 1, go ahead and switch sides. You're coming down when you need, but stick with the hold for as long as you can. Keep it up, you got 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, whoo. It should be burning by the time we're done with this circuit. Nice work, you guys. 30 second recovery, and we're moving into our push-ups. So, pick your option. We're going in about 3, 2, 1. 3 seconds on the way down. 3, 2, 1. Hold at the bottom. 1 second on the way up. Ten seconds, stick with the movement. Lower for a full 3 Mississippis. 3, 2, 1. Recover, you guys. Really nice work. 30 second recovery. We're moving into our step, squat, and shoot. Remember, you can do low impact or high impact, but go for speed, okay? All right, we're going in 3, 2, 1, here we go. Right, and then left. Jog back to the start. Or if you're doing low impact, jump out and march back. You can go faster than me, you can go slower than me, but you're gonna stick with the movement and get deep into that squat. Load out of the leg. You got 7 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Recover, guys. All right, so that should really be your, it should start peaking your heart rate, okay? 30 seconds and we're right back to the start with those single leg hip bridge with knee extension or your single leg RDL. Grab a sip of water. You've got 10 seconds. Start making your way down unless you're doing single leg RDL. And we're starting in 3, 2, 1. I will tell you when to switch. You're holding for as long as you can. For that 15 seconds, you're in single leg RDL. Think about squeezing those thighs together. Go ahead and switch sides. Remember your options, guys. You can keep that knee at 90 degrees. We're so close, keep holding it. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it down. Nice work, you guys. Whew. Booty's on fire. Okay, back to our eccentric push-ups. Your option. We're gonna get going in 3, 2, 1. Take your option. Anytime we're doing this eccentric work, what you're focusing on is decelerating. You're fighting gravity as gravity pulls your body into the ground. Keep with it, guys. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Nice work, you guys. Woofy. All right, back to our step, squat, shoot. You've got 15 seconds, so keep breathing. Pull that breath deep into the belly. Reset your headspace. 5 seconds. We're step, squat, shooting. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. You can go a little faster than you did last time. You get a little deeper in that squat than you did last time. Let's work, you guys. 10 seconds. You can fit 2 more reps in that. Recover. Thank you, guys. Grab your water. We're gonna go one more round. As you're recovering, think about what I said last time about trying to pull your breath equally divided between your belly and your lungs. To really maximize the efficiency of your airflow. All right, guys, 10 seconds and we're back to our single leg hip bridge or your single leg RDL. We're going in 5, three, two, one. Let's go, guys. Your last set of this circuit, so give it your all. Squeeze those thighs together if you're in single leg RDL. Go ahead and switch sides, y'all. If you want to challenge your balance, bring those arms in front of you. Three, two, one, recover. Nice work, you guys. Can you kiss those goodbye? We're moving back to our eccentric push-ups. So think decelerating. You're decelerating against gravity as you pull yourself into the floor. All right, three, two, one. Let's go, guys. Last round of push-ups. 3 seconds on that lowering phase. Make sure those low backs are not sinking. Think about your action figure. 5 seconds, you got it. Three, two, push, push, push. Recover. Nice work, you guys. All right, last round, step, squat, shoot. I want you to see how many you can get in, whether you're high impact, low impact, I don't care. Let's go for speed. These are speed step, squat, shoot. We're going in. 5 seconds. Three, two, one. Last round. Drain that tank. You're gonna get a nice recovery before our finisher. Stay. 5 seconds. Three, two, one. Thank you, guys. Woo. All right. Give you another little bit longer of a recovery, full 60 seconds. I'll tell you what we're doing. Man, I hate when I have to explain over this song, because I love this song. Okay, while you're recovering, breathing into your belly, our finisher today, we have our energy systems training. It's your cardio peak. So listen to your body and make it count. You're gonna gas the tank, whatever's left in there. First, we have something called suicide drills, and this is how that works. I'll go ahead and demo this one. You're taking 2 runs, and then you're gonna drop down. It kind of almost looks like a shuffle. So 2 runs, and then tap the ground. So you're going down and up a lot here. That's option one. Option two is a lateral sidestep to squat. So, lateral sidestep, squat. Lateral sidestep, squat. You are going for speed here, okay? Speed and distance in the step that you take. That's what you're going for there if you're low impact today. Next move, we have top of push-up hold. Three, Nico's gonna demo this one for us. Go ahead and face the other way. Yeah. So we're in top of push-up hold. We have 3 mountain climbers. So you're gonna do 3 knees, go ahead. 3 mountain climbers. Yep. And then a jump in and a jump out. Okay. You don't have to jump in quite as far as he did. Go ahead and show us jumping in about halfway. Totally fine. Just jump in as far as you can. Or if you prefer to step in and then out, that's great too. Whatever option feels best for your body today is the option that will maximize your workout. Option there. If you're gonna be standing, is standing mountain climbers here. So opposite arm, opposite leg. You can go fast, or you can do low impact, still going for speed, okay? All of those options are hard. Not necessarily that some are easier than others. Some just might be better suited for different joint pain, joint things going on. All right, we are gonna get through as many rounds as possible in the next. We're gonna see if we can get through 4 or maybe even 5. So prepare to drain that tank. I'm gonna give you another 30 seconds. Well, let's do another 15. I'm gonna get the music going. We're gonna start with either your suicide drills or your lateral sidestep to squat. All right, lateral sidestep to squat. Okay, we are going in 5, 3, 2, 1. If you're doing suicide drills, you're with me. Even halfway. Five, three, two, one. Woo! Holy cow. Okay, those should definitely peak your heart rate. You got 30 seconds of recovery. And then Nico's got our top of push-up, 3 mountain climbers and jumping in and out. Or if you're with me, standing. All right, we're going in 10. Catch that breath. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1. Remember, you can do both of these options. Low impact. It up. Stick with the movement. 5 seconds, you guys are there. Don't give up. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Woo! Breathe, breathe, breathe. All right, another 15 seconds of recovery, and we're back to it. All right, we're going in 5, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Short recovery. Remember, you can go faster than me, or you can go slower. Your workout. In seconds, don't give up. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Seconds. Where you guys recover the fastest? Do you feel more recovery personally with your hands behind your head or bent over? All right, we're gonna go in 3, 2, 1. Mountain climbers. We're halfway, guys. Remember why you showed up today. Because I'm pretty sure you didn't show up for me. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Got 2 or 3. Keep taking little sips of water. That H2O out to the muscles. All right, we're going back to suicide drills. 10 seconds. Guys, remember you can always switch up your options in the middle of a set too. You start out doing suicide drills, you decide you want to move to lateral squats. Okay. All right, guys. Sorry, I actually gave us a little longer. 5 seconds, we're going back to suicide drills. 3, 2, 1. Up left. We have one more round after this. All fact that you have less than 10 seconds left. Do anything for 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Good golly, Aunt Dolly. Holy cow. 20 seconds. And we're back to those mountain climbers. Breathe big, breathe deep. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. That left foot on the gas pedal. This is it, you guys. One more round. Remember your low impact options. Keep it up. Pure low impact. Keep up the speed. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Recover. Oh, man. One more round, you guys. I'm going to give us a full 60-second recovery before our last round. Really let those heart rates come down. Maximize these last 90 seconds.
Quick question. What heart rate do we want to be at? What's a good like heart rate to be at?
You know, if you have a heart rate monitor on, are you looking at percentage of max heart rate or at what your heart rate is?
What my heart rate is. Sorry, you can just stop the thing.
Oh, no, you're totally fine. That's gonna vary for everybody, because everybody's max heart rate is different. I can help you figure out what your max heart rate is. That's Barry that's talking, right? I can help you figure that out, and then you'll wanna go off the percentage. But you wanna be between like 70 and 85% for a peak. But I will help you with that, Barry, I promise. Okay, you guys ready for our last round? We're gonna start in 5 seconds. The last round of suicide drills, last round of mountain climbers. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Drain that tank, you guys. More than halfway. Up, 5 seconds left. We're so close. Push. 1 second. Recover. Oh my gosh. Nice work, you guys. 30 seconds. There are less than 60 seconds of your entire workout for the day. You guys have got this. Stay strong. All right. You guys have 15 seconds. Breathe deep. Make that recovery count to the last one. Five seconds and we're going. Last 30 seconds of the workout. 3, 2, 1. Ask yourself now. You got 20 seconds left. All right, team, all together. Last 10 seconds. We're gonna do an all-out sprint. Ready? 3, 2, 1, let's go. All-out sprint. Three, two, one. Oh my gosh. Holy cow, you guys. Grab a big sip of water. guys. We're gonna cool you down. Nico's gonna start stretching me out. I'll be right back. I thought I would unmute if you guys can hear me. Nico doesn't have a mic. Abby made herself throw up. She was teaching so hard. I'm so sorry, you guys. You should be following Nico. Get a nice twist in the spine. What did you guys do already? Hip flexor? Cool, okay. Once you get a good stretch in that spine, we'll come up to standing. All right, guys, let's come back into our down or into our down dog. We didn't do those during our ramp. So go ahead and walk into that down dog. If you haven't done down dog before, you're driving those hips up into the sky. It's okay if the knees are bent, but you're working on keeping a flat back. The flatter your back is, you may need to bend your knees more, and that's okay. Slide those shoulder blades into your back pockets, down your spine. If you want to pedal the feet, you can. Go for what feels good to your body. If you want to sink those heels into the ground, you may have to bend your back a little bit more, but you can get a deeper stretch down the calves. Kind of play around in this position. And then when you're ready, go ahead and roll into that top of push-up hold. And then go ahead and come down to the knees. We're going to get a little stretch in the neck today, guys. If you want to stay seated, you can. If you want to be standing, A-okay. Grab the head just over the ear. And then very gently pull the head directly that way. You're not pulling down. You're pulling to the side. Just getting a nice gentle stretch down this trap muscle. And go ahead and switch sides. You guys want to know a trick? If you're ever feeling really tight right here, if you do this stretch and then in this hand you hold a little weight, you can just hold a soup can or something. It really deepens the stretch down into your shoulder. All right, let's just finish off with a few neck rolls. You can come to standing if you want. A couple each way. And then go ahead and just get a few twists in the upper back. Rub those elbows. Lift off the heel. That's not too much of a twist. You guys are awesome. Thank you guys so much for joining today, for showing up for yourself, getting a good sweat on. I always get really sweaty, so thanks for sweating with me. I hope you guys have a fabulous Thursday and that your day's a little bit better because of the endorphins that you gave yourself, that you gifted yourself this morning. Have a fantastic day, and I will see you guys all soon. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Abby. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye.